So today we're going to talk about rock, paper, scissors. I reckon everyone knows how to play it. Scissors beats paper. Paper covers rock. Rock blunts scissors. So three
Well, I
strategies.
always thought it smashed it.
Oh, I thought it blunts them. Actually, if anything, it probably sharpened them, right? There's three strategies. Each one of them loses once and wins once. So it looks like there's no strategy that you can play to win, but I'm going to show you about a new paper that's just come out, which gives you some top tips of how to win. So it's a group of Chinese scientists where they ran an experiment where they got 360 students to play games of rock, paper, scissors with one another. 300 rounds in every game, which took up to 2 hours, which is astonishing. Students playing rock, paper, scissors for 2 hours. Okay, so normally, if you have rock, paper, scissors, so you have rock up there, and rock is beaten by paper, which is then beaten by scissors. So none of these strategies dominate the other. So really, all you can do is play each strategy with an equal probability, a third, a third, a third, okay? Now, if you were playing against a computer who is choosing these perfectly randomly, then that would be the best thing for you to do, is just to pick each strategy with equal probability. But the thing is that humans are quite predictably irrational, shall we say, in the way that they choose their strategies. So in recording what all of these students did in playing rock, paper, scissors, the scientists came up with two quite important findings of how people try and beat each other. Okay, so the first one is that people who win tend to repeat their strategy. So, for example, if I beat you by playing rock, there is a very high chance or high probability that I will play rock again the second time. If it worked once, it's going to work again, right? But the second thing that they found out is that losers change.
To anything in particular, or?
Well, so this is the thing that you can exploit, essentially. So if you know, so this gives us, I suppose, two strategies that we can use. So the first tip is that if you lose, that means the other person just won, right? So let's imagine that your opponent won by playing rock. Now, the chances are that they're going to play rock again, so you should then play paper. So you just lost on scissors, so you should play paper, which means that basically, even though paper beats rock, so the sort of cycle goes around like this, paper beats rock and so on, you should go the other way around the triangle. Let's imagine that you played scissors, the other person played rock. What you should do is you should go backwards around this triangle and play paper the next time, because there's a high chance that they're going to play rock again. So that's the first thing. So go backwards, I guess. Or another way to say it is essentially, you've just played scissors, they've played rock, so play the thing that didn't come up in that if you lose. Now, the second thing is that if you've just won, now they're going to expect you to play the same thing again, right? Which means that they're going to play the thing that would beat the thing that you just played. So you need to play the thing that would beat the thing that would beat the thing that you just played, which is equivalent to saying you need to play what they just played. So find it. Okay, again.
I like the easy way better. So you should play what they just
Well,
played.
you should play what they just played, yeah. So let's imagine then you just won, you played rock, right? And you just won on rock. That means that they played scissors. Now they're going to think that you're going to play rock again, which means that they're going to play paper, which means that you should play scissors. And so again, you basically end up going backwards around the triangle. So play what they just played and again go backwards. Or an easier way to say it then is play what they just played. So in general then, if you're cycling through rock, paper, scissors, your best strategy is to go backwards and go scissors, paper, rock and cycle through that way.
Is this mathematics or is this psychology? Is this like this is I can't tell if this is like all to do with probabilities and stuff, or it's just about knowing how humans think.
Well, I think it's a balance of the two. So it's rooted in game theory, which is the mathematics of looking at decisions and strategies. So in any situation where you're competing against someone and your best move is dependent on what the other person is playing, you can frame it in game theory.
Numberphile is brought to you by the Mathematical Sciences Research Institute, but this video has also been sponsored by Squarespace. Squarespace is a great service for designing, hosting, creating your own websites, and as I've probably mentioned before, I use it myself. No matter what you want to do, a blog, podcast, shop, portfolio, Squarespace is as easy as 1, 2, 3. But it's not just amateurs who'll benefit from Squarespace and all its brilliant templates. Their developer platform will also give you full control over all the code, letting you tweak the HTML, CSS, and JavaScript until your heart's content. And if you like stats, and you are watching Numberphile, you'll really like Squarespace's analytics, their third-party integrations, and their easy-to-use commerce. If you'd like to find out more, go to squarespace.com/numberphile. You can try it all out, you can set up your own site, and you can do it all for free, no credit card required. And then if you do like it and decide to opt in, use the offer code NUMBERPHILE and you'll get 10% off. So thank you very much to Squarespace for supporting this video. And thank you to you for watching it.